Landfall along the coast of Florida's Big Bend near Keaton Beach is a strong Category 3 storm around 7:45 this morning.
NBC2 anchor Alan Campbell is in Perry, Florida, just about 20 miles away from where the storm made landfall. Alan.
Well, Kelly and Peter, you know, the people here in Perry are really starting to come together. They're not wasting any time as a community coming together to clear up the debris and any of the damage that was left behind. In fact, just about 10 minutes or so ago, this road that's right beside me here, it was covered with trees. But there was a gentleman who brought his tractor down and actually cleared out all the trees and all the debris so that cars can go through here. The lady that is going into this home over here, look at her front yard. Look at all the debris that is on top of her roof. It's a common sight here in this small American town where we're seeing a lot of debris, branches, trees scattered all over people's houses. And unfortunately, take a look at this. This is another thing we're seeing a lot here in the town of Perry. These trees that are uprooted and blown over, laying literally all over people's yards and on the roadways. But I really want to bring your eyes and your attention to this over here. Those winds were so strong from Hurricane Idalia when it came here on shore, probably about 110, 120 miles per hour, ripped this tin roof right off of this business here and then toss that tin roof across over here, maybe about 75 yards in front of the postal service here in Perry, in front of a major thoroughfare, US 221. But you know what? As I mentioned earlier, the people here in Perry, they are coming together. They know the importance of being together as a community and helping each other out, similar to what we are doing in Southwest Florida nearly a year after Hurricane Ian, as we also continue to rebuild. But I want to show you something here that stood up to Hurricane Idalia. Mitch, can you zoom in on that? That is a sign of hope here for the people in Perry. That is Old Glory. High above on that pole, stood there the entire time and is flying right now in the wind. If there's anything that says that this city, the people here in Perry will rebuild, it's that sign of the American flag right there. But again, you know, really, there is a lot of damage out here in Perry. Some of the folks we spoke to, they say they've never really seen a storm this intense, this powerful. They've had storms before. They didn't expect it to cause this much damage. But again, it's great to see, really, a lot of these people coming together, helping clean out and repair some of the damages, cut down trees, making sure that they can get to their destinations. Unfortunately, power hasn't been restored. Just a few moments ago as well, we saw major power companies from all over, not just here in Florida, but from Georgia, from North Carolina. They were all rolling down the street here. Again, that major thoroughfare setting up. They're going to try and get that power back up as quickly as possible to the folks here in Perry. We'll continue to monitor the situation here and bring you any new updates. For now, reporting live in Perry, I'm Alan Campbell. We'll send it back to you guys.
Alan, thank you. People.